Dear Anshams, medical students, welcome to Anatomy Flipped Learning Project. Bones of the lower limb, part 2, will include tibia, fibula, and the skeleton of the foot. Tibia and the fibula are long bones of the leg. The tibia is the medial bone of the leg, while the fibula is the lateral bone of the leg. General features of tibia and the fibula on the anterior view include: number 1, medial condyle of the tibia. Number 2, lateral condyle of the tibia. Number 3, the intercondylar eminence from the superior aspect of the tibia. Number 4, the tibial tuberosity on the anterior aspect of the tibia. Number 5, the anterior border or shin of the tibia. Number 6 is the interosseous border of the tibia, which is directed laterally towards the fibula. Number 7, the medial border of the tibia. Number 8, the medial malleolus at the lower end of the tibia. Number 9 is the styloid process of the fibula, which is the apex of the head of the fibula directed posterolaterally. Number 10, the head of the fibula. Number 11, neck of the fibula. Number 12 is the lateral malleolus at the lower end of the fibula. General features on posterior view of tibia and the fibula include: number 1, medial condyle of the tibia. Number 2, lateral condyle of tibia. Number 3, intercondylar eminence. Number 4, fibular facet of tibia, which lies on the posteroinferior aspect of the lateral condyle of the tibia. Number 5, soleal line on posterior surface of the tibia. Number 6, interosseous border of the tibia, which is directed laterally towards the fibula. Number 7, medial border of tibia. Number 8, vertical line on posterior surface of tibia. Number 9, medial malleolus of the tibia. Number 10, fibular notch of the tibia, which lies on the lateral aspect of the lower end of the tibia directed towards the fibula. Number 11, styloid process or apex of the head of the fibula. Number 12, head of fibula. Number 13, neck of fibula. Number 14, lateral malleolus at lower end of the fibula. Number 15 is the malleolar fossa on the medial aspect of the lateral malleolus of the fibula. Joints related to the tibia are 5 joints. Number 1, knee joint related to the upper surfaces of the medial and the lateral tibial condyles. Knee joint is a bicondylar synovial joint, or functionally it is a modified hinge synovial joint. The tibia is related to 3 tibiofibular joints. Number 2 refers to superior or proximal tibiofibular joint, which is related to the fibular facet of the tibia. Superior or proximal tibiofibular joint is a plane synovial joint. Number 3 is the middle tibiofibular joint, formed by the interosseous membrane of the leg. This joint is a fibrous joint. Number 4 is the inferior or distal tibiofibular joint related to the fibular notch on the lower end of the tibia. The inferior or distal tibiofibular joint is a fibrous joint or syndesmosis. So, the joints related to the tibia are number one, knee joint, number two, superior or proximal tibiofibular joint, number three, middle tibiofibular joint formed by the interosseous membrane of the leg, number four, inferior or distal tibiofibular joint. The fifth joint, number five, is the ankle or talocrural joint, which is related to the inferior articular surface of the lower end of the tibia. Ankle joint is a hinge synovial joint. Dear students, review again. Number one, name the market joint. Number two, mention its type. Number one, two, three, four, and five. Related tendons include, number one, tendon of tibialis posterior related to a groove on the back of the medial malleolus of the tibia. Number two, tendon of peroneus brevis related to a groove on the back of the lateral malleolus of the fibula. 10 muscles are attached to the tibia. Number one, ligamentum patelli. Number two, insertion of SGS, sartorius, gracilis, and semitendinosus arranged from before backward. Number three, insertion of semimembranosus muscle into a groove on the back of the medial condyle of the tibia. Number four, insertion of the popliteus muscle. Number five, origin of soleus muscle. Number six, origin of tibialis anterior. Number seven, origin of tibialis posterior, lateral to the vertical line. Number eight, origin of flexor digitorum longus, medial to the vertical line. And the number nine, the attachment of the iliotibial tract to the front of the lateral condyle of the tibia. So, to review again the attached muscles to the tibia. Number one is the attachment of ligamentum patelli. Number two, SGS, sartorius, gracilis, and semitendinosus arranged from before backward. Number three, semimembranosus. Number four, popliteus muscle. Number five, soleus. Number six, tibialis anterior. Number seven, tibialis posterior. Number eight, flexor digitorum longus. Number nine, the iliotibial tract. For identification of the side of the tibia, number one, tibial condyles are directed up. Number two, tibial tuberosity is directed anteriorly. Number three, medial malleolus is directed medially. Put the bone on yourself to confirm its side, right or left. This bone is a right tibia. Just for knowledge, to identify the side of the fibula, put the malleolar fossa down medial and posterior, like a spoon. Skeleton of the foot is divided into three regions, tarsus, metatarsus, and phalanges. Tarsal bones are seven short bones arranged in the form of proximal row, two bones, which are number one, calcaneus, number two, talus. In front of the proximal row, there is a medial bone, which is the navicular bone number three. The distal row of the tarsal bones include four bones arranged from medial to lateral side. Number four, the medial cuneiform bone. Number five, the intermediate cuneiform bone. Number six, the lateral cuneiform bone. Number seven, cuboid bone. There are five metatarsal bones arranged first to fifth from medial to lateral side. First metatarsal bone is that of the big two, while fifth metatarsal bone is that of the little two. Phalanges are 14 in number, 2 for the big two, proximal and the distal phalanges, and the 3 for the other lateral 4 toes, proximal, middle and the distal phalanges. Dear students, my best wishes.